can't get over all the nuts. There ain't nothing eating any of these nuts. Acorns and hickory nuts and And we found some persimmon seeds and some poop up there on the road, so there's a persimmon grove around here somewhere, probably coyotes. Lots of hair in the poop.
Not black like a bug.
Gold.
I am gonna bust out my flex reel and I'm gonna kick back and I gotta go in the pine.
Wish I had a problem with flex reel.
This is awesome. I've got an open strip on it.
May as well take the easy way around here.
How legal is that to bring back into the
state?
Oh, not. Oh, it is legal. It clears it? Customs.
Oh, really?
Yep.
Probably bound by amount, though. You can only bring so much back.
Your dad up there, your house. It's just like anything you bring in customs.
Declare it? And
you don't even have to declare it as far as item by item.
Yeah.
And we had a customs officer tell us this when we came back in off our cruise in New Orleans. He said, we don't need to know what everything is, because we had listed amoxicillin
yeah.
and flexoril, because we didn't want them saying, oh, well, you can't bring this back in. Right. If they told us we couldn't, it wasn't any big deal.
Right. You didn't want to be charged with something.
Right. If we couldn't legally bring it back, we weren't too worried about it. But he said, look, we don't need a big list, because then there's a lot of questions asked when it's a new guy here saying, well, I don't know, can they bring this? Can they bring this? He said,
make life easier for everybody.
Each one of you can bring $400 worth back in. Cigarettes, tobacco, any tobacco, alcohol, as long as it's not Cuban. You can put cigars, we'll ask you, are they Cuban? If you say yes, we confiscate them. If you say no, more than likely we let them go. Occasionally we pull one and check. Said alcohol, as long as you're not over the amount you can bring back, we don't even check. Said just if you bring back alcohol, put down like a quantity, because you're like allowed to bring back, I think, a maximum of 2 gallons, 4 half-gallon jars.
Wow, but, that's a lot.
Yeah.
I mean, unless you're a serious drinker, but I mean.
And that's per person.
That's a half day supply.
Yeah, right. One trip.
You can bring back 2 cartons of cigarettes per person of legal age. You know, like I couldn't buy.
That's not very much.
I couldn't buy 2 cartons for my kid, each one of my kids, and be for me and declare it, because they couldn't legally buy them here.
Right.
But said, like prescription, stuff like that, you've bought out of the country. Said just put souvenirs and then give us a rough amount of what you spent. You have up to, I think you said, as a married couple, you have $800 between y'all and $400 for your 2 kids.
Wow.
So you could bring back $1,200 of the stuff and just say souvenirs, and we're not going to think anything about it.
Right.
I said, that's good to know, because the next time I go to Mexico, I'm going to come back looking like a fucking farmer.
Just be sure you bring back a bottle with a worm in it.
They are mezcal. Awful picky about letting that mezcal actually cross the border.
Yeah, they don't like that.
Regular tequila, they will let come across. Mezcal, they do not want it crossing the border. I did see two bottles of mezcal confiscated.
Look, Sasquatch was wearing boots with treads.
Yep.
Yeah, we walked this pretty steady last night.
I figured.
Oh, yeah.
Right here is where we set up running the parabolic mic after the ladies did that hike.
Ah.
We set up right here using this little scrub to break up our shapes.
Well, does this not look like the area where Patty was filmed?
Oh, it really crazy once you get out of this shit and look back up. Matter of fact, the track is pretty eerily reminiscent of Patty's.
Got some fresh flowing water coming down from spring.
This is nothing.
Right over there is
right over there's the flowing water. This is just a little offshoot. That's built up blocking and trickles. There's bona fide flowing water in the oven.
Good place for something to get a drink.
So right here's the cast.
Well, it ought to be dry by now.
It was old, wasn't a lot of definition.
That's a big boy.
It's over 18 inches long. And it was, the only reason we found it was because it was embedded in all of that dead shit.
And it left a real deep impression for you.
But it's right foot, and we found the left a little bit farther up, but it just kind of bananaed, like it was on the outside edge of its foot.
Not worthy of casting.
And then it angled right through that and headed towards
right
that,
over that
dead
over
tree.
Over the tree.
Since we're here, I'll take you back here, show you what we got excited about. Matter of fact, after I get back to camp, get that brisket, I'm coming back out. I got some looking around I need to do pretty serious.
Well, this is a good looking area. Really?
As they say on finding Bigfoot, it's fixing to get squatchy. And it is. It's going to get real squatchy real quick here in just a minute. We found a bear track coming out of here yesterday.
Yeah, but did you find any bear crap?
That we did not find.
Because then you could answer that age-old question.
There's bear shit.
Right. In the knot hole. Perfect place for a camera, huh? Yeah. Spy camera.
Now, say we actually found an old construction road from where they built the lake. And it's blocked off. And that's where we found all the weird, crazy shit you kind of heard us talking about last night. About if you had brake, fatal funnel, any of that shit singular, it'd be pretty impressive. But to have it all at one spot is just kind of crazy.
And these guys, they got long legs. I have to short leg it. You okay?
Yeah. Talking about grabbing a tree.
There's your fatal funnel.
Yes, sir.
Got your roadblock. There's actually a squat in here where you can tell it actually sat down.
Look closely for hair.
See right in here.
Like an armadillo hole right here. Uh-huh. All that brunch broken down. Uh-huh. And the ground's pushed down. Something's been sitting or laying in here. Like you'd think there'd be hair.
Everything angles up. Well, it's fairly old, so
everything would be degraded anyway, but it'd just be interesting to find a little piece of hair or something that would confirm something laying under there.
Let's see what I think it's doing, Miss, because I made sure I kept everybody out of this.
Uh-huh.
Because I did not want the contamination
right
from us stomping around in it till we had somebody that actually looks for the stuff, because I don't. You know, I can find it.
But then you're ready to move on to the next thing.
I'm ready to sit there and go, this shit is wild. Let's find why it's here.
Which way it came from and which way it's going.
But that's kind of like this big ass break and start of a new structure.
Mm-hmm.
That's pretty impressive damn break.
Yeah. And this is the old road right here.
This is the old road right here.
Yeah.
And it's essentially just about this clear the whole way down, because we found it.
So that's your first clue, is probably
easy
as far as where it comes from or goes, is it's going to be using this trail a lot.
Now,
it's,
see, I have.
Why wouldn't it? You know, it's an easy.
Yeah, we've noticed that almost all the logging roads around here that skirt the mountains, there's always signage on it.
Yeah, they're real well traveled.
But see, you got a bow there, and then you got the tree pushed down here.
That
you've got a choke point there.
Actually bent down and pressed against.
Yeah,
it's
wedged
into
another tree.
Yeah.
Now, see, I've always had a theory on the hunting about that. If you find a spot that looks like it's well traveled, easily traveled, you always go up, because there's going to be one to match it on the high side. We found one on the high side. At one point, it's about 15 feet wide. You could drive a truck down through it.
Wow. That's what you call a tall boy trail.
Yeah, when you get up to that point from about where we're standing, it veers off. Now, we call them bull rush lanes because it'll be a straight trail coming down, almost an ambush trail where they get ahead of steam.
Right.
When you step right through here,
You can see
the packing on the dirt, the ground, the leaves,
mm-hmm.
right down the side.
Mm-hmm.
And there's about six of them we found between here and where the spring pulls up. And that was the first thing that gave us some real
hope
and looking, was where the spring pulled.
Well, what do you think about that print? Did you look around to see where it came from or where it went?
It came from up in here. That's one reason why we were following the spring.
You were backtracking back here.
Yeah. Because based on the dimensions of that and the age of it, it's pretty close to the tracks that we were finding on the other side. So I know where it's going. It's coming to us. So it was, how's it coming in? Because that's going to tell us the best way to set cameras.
Right, right.
And the best areas to look in, and everything I found so far is telling me that we need to be back up in here. From this cove to this mountain and back.
It's where they're currently using, huh?
Yeah. And I figure it's primarily because of the clear cut. When you first come in, they've pushed back in here.
That and...
Yeah.
You go this way and there's that big, huge cut-in cove that where that big creek dumps into.
So that serves as a natural boundary. Hey.
Because it's so congested, it's kind of hard to
go. They're going to keep going back there. Do you want to just head on out? You can head on back? Or do you want to keep going?
Yeah. I think you're starting to bark again.
Yeah, mine too. My back is starting to hurt. I was thinking this. Hey,
John?
Hey, John? We're going to head back.
All right. We've been walking for about 3 hours.
All right. I tell you what, we'll come on out too and go give y'all a ride up the camp.
So well, I mean, we know y'all are anxious to check this out. You're here. We're okay. We can walk out of here.
Did Quartz take pictures of this?
Yeah.
Good. I took a few myself.
On that little camera.
I took a couple myself.
See, I want to grab a bite to eat and handle that brisket.
There you
back
go.
Out here.
There you go.
Yeah, it's 12:30 now.
We're a couple of old men. I shouldn't speak for Perry, but I'm an old man, and I'm ready to go back for a while. But we've seen some beautiful, beautiful areas.
Me, I can tough it out. You know,
Oh, yeah.
Don't need to. We can always come back out here.
But I know they're anxious to get back up in there, and I thought, well...
They're going to have to come back for cast.
True.
And they're also going to have to come back to put the
cameras
out.
Great spot area.
I'm gold hunting right now.
Yeah, Vaina.
I'm for, you know, they find gold a little farther up the river.
Really?
In quartz.
And gold typically settles in quartz, and then as the quartz erodes over time, washes out. So I'm pretty sure.
You like to see those quartz veins because you know that's a possibility for something.
Yeah.
Nearby.
See, this is one of those places that if you don't get out and don't look, you don't find it.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
If you just look at it from the coast, it's like, it ain't nothing but like the hills. You go to trying to find headwaters on springs. Yeah, you find
then you start to find
stuff.
Gotcha. Yeah, drive operator would like to come out here. Randy, Yeah. He would probably just camp out here. He would just camp out here.
Randy and him, they cut across, the water was down last
year.
And they were able to cut.
Oh, okay.
He never had to ease back.
He didn't know any of this back here.
Picked up with the shoreline and followed around.
So they were just following the shoreline.
Me and Michael walked in and went back where the hill makes the turn, and we went up and over. They went around, we went up and over. Nobody ever accused us of being proud. I did yesterday. I pulled that big one up.
Oh.
I was looking for shell to bust loose to stack around the cast to kind of reinforce it.
Oh,